done for us. If this is your first time to St. Joseph's, we give you a special welcome. We are privileged to use the Maronite ritual of the Catholic faith. The Lord be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Thank you.
sweet fragrance through our good works and actions. Hear our petitions, and grant rest to our departed in your dwelling places of joy. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Amen.
Peace.
Let us rejoice in it and be glad.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, who proclaimed life to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of life and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, O listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the Word of the living God.
At that same hour, Jesus rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows who the Son is except the Father, or who the Father is except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Then turning to the disciples, Jesus said to them privately, Blessed are the eyes that see what you see. For I tell you that many prophets and kings desired to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. This is the truth. Peace be with you. Position and status and power, We are not always aware of how dependent we are on God. The Maronite prayer said it very beautifully when we were asking the Father to breathe life back into the dead. That's what they're talking about. There isn't anybody that I've ever met that had the power to breathe on somebody who was dead and bring them back to life. That without the Spirit, without this breath, and if you remember from the first chapter of Genesis, God brought life into the world by breathing on the water. And that's why whenever in the Maronite Rite we bless holy water, we breathe upon it in the sign of the cross to bring life into it. And so, really, from the moment of our existence, we have this conflict and tension, dynamic, trying to not continue through life being self-centered and trying to depend or rely on the Lord and trust in His will. That even when our own desires and wishes don't come out the way we want them, if they are in harmony with God's will, the blessing will come our way. The next part that I reflected on was, what do I see in life? What am I trying to see? It's said that the prophets and kings and all these people were looking for, trying to see it, and they couldn't see it. And it's not because they're physically blind, but sometimes we blind ourselves. Because we are imperfect, because we have egos, because we gravitate towards wanting power and position, and there is a proper place for that. We do need to have good, sound leadership. There are people who have gifts that we don't have that are able to do some things more well or better than us. I think one of the mistakes in the priesthood is that very often they, or including us priests, think that as soon as the bishop anoints us with the oil and lays his hands on it and says the prayer, we all of a sudden know everything and try to lead like we know everything. And that's an impossible equation. But that's also true in every profession. I bet everybody here who has had a job has had to work for somebody who acted like they knew it all, and they didn't. And they made the workplace absolutely miserable. Or they envied for a position of control and yet couldn't handle it. It's the messiness of life, even among the apostles. They did not handle themselves very well all the time and got in trouble for it. And going back to, what do I see? Do I see the most important thing? Do I tend to see the flaws and the mistakes more than their another person's sanctity, value, or dignity? Am I able to see the whole picture so that I don't wind up going blind with my own feelings getting in the way? Can I lose touch with the feelings and the emotions of others because I have been trampled upon? We've all been stepped on. Sometimes intentionally, sometimes not intentionally. But sometimes, like a little baby, we have to learn not to wake up at 5 a.m. or 3 a.m. in the morning and immediately cry. We're adults now. We're spiritual people now. We have the opportunity to pray and reflect and walk with the Heavenly Father and to search out in what way can the pain that I carry, and that's not to minimize any hurt or any pain that we might carry, but in what way can we carry it so that it does not fester and destroy and become infected and begin to smell? Or what way can we put our life before our loving and compassionate God and let Him use the salve of healing? The prayers talked about the aroma of our good works in our prayers. It's a way of saying that everything we do makes a difference. We are always in the process of becoming more healthy or less healthy. The way I see it is that God and Jesus had to command us to love one another because sometimes we won't make that decision on our own. As we continue to grow, sometimes we have to return to being an infant and reabsorb, reassess, relook at what are we looking at, what are we seeing. I know that I have terrible writing skills with grammar and dyslexia and having letters switched around and words in the wrong place. But I have to look beyond that. When the words express, sometimes the only way we can see and come in touch with the compassion and the mercy that God has for us is to be willing to untangle the mess that's before us and let what's meant to be noticed and meant to be discovered, meant to be believed, to transcend beyond all the imperfections of who we are and see how the Heavenly Father has sent His Son into the world to bring peace to it, to bring comfort, sending His Holy Spirit to console us in the times that we need it. What do you hear? What do I hear? What do I remember of what I have heard throughout the week? I know I heard Hawaiian music because I listen to it every day. But certainly beyond that, they say that we should all have types of music that soothe us and bring tranquility back into our life. But we certainly need to have a firm rock foundation. Can I hear God trying to get closer to me? Can I see how He's trying to enter into my woundedness and imperfections? And He knows that He can still glorify Himself through all of this. Can I hear Him? There is a gospel song, gently, quietly, Jesus is calling. It always gives me goosebumps when I hear it, because that is His way. Each one of us, like a little baby, listening to the gentle voice of their mother or their father. The way you calm the baby is gently, softly, carefully, and tenderly. Hold them. I remember visiting a family in Danbury it was the first baby among the relatives, and they were just absolutely filled with anxiety. Oh my gosh, they called the priest because he's from a family of nine. Been around babies, and I took the baby and immediately stopped crying. I said, how'd you do that? And I thought of this song. But I told him that, you know, a baby senses the anxieties and the fears and the turmoil of the mother and the grandmother too. When a baby cries, it doesn't mean it doesn't love you. When a baby cries, that doesn't necessarily mean you're a bad mother or grandmother or a situ or a jitu or father. Babies cry, and they need the right response. But in so many ways, some things never change in our lives. There are certain moments when we feel pain, when we lost somebody that we love so much, that if we don't cry outwardly, maybe we cry inwardly. And the right response remains the same. Today, as I say almost every Sunday, during the liturgy, there is an exchange taking place. We're giving him all that we're struggling with, and we exchange it for the amount of times that we need to hear mercy, compassion, forgiveness.
For us.
remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us. We recall upon this offering all those who please God from Adam to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered for freedom. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Son, and the communion drawn of the Holy Spirit be with you
my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our thoughts and minds and our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord with reverence and worship him with humility.
It is right and just.
With high mind and tongue we give you thanks, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one true God. Join spiritually to the invisible choirs and countless ranks of angels. Your faithful people glorify you with them and three times proclaim, Holy.
Praise you, we bless you, we worship you.
Gregory Dunner Bishop, and all the bishops of the true faith, and with blameless lives and in purity and holiness, may they guide your church and present you a faithful people who honor your name. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, remember those who do good, free those bound by hardships, liberate the poor, and visit those who are dejected, distressed, and weary. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, be a fortification for every city and country that truly believes in you and takes refuge in you. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those who struggle with chronic illness, anxiety, and pain in their lives, that they will find healing and comfort in the Lord. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and a consecrated life to serve the Maronite Church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, strengthen those who call upon Mary, the mother of your Son, Jesus Christ, and the saints who have pleased you, especially St. Joseph, St. Jude, St. Maron, and St. Charlotte. Through your grace, make us and our departed worthy of the eternal blessings that you have prepared for your saints. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, forgive the faithful departed, especially Frida, who have been redeemed by the death of your only Son, and on that day, when all are rescued from death, delivered from the realm of the dead, and raised from the dust of the grave, the grace of your only Son will have been glorified in us and in them. Through him, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Great grace of God to the departed, and lead us to sins we have committed, with and without full knowledge.
O Lord, in the resurrection on the last day, when all is renewed, make us and our departed worthy through your grace of the joy of your heavenly kingdom. In us and in all things, may your blessed and most honored name be glorified, praised and exalted with the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, it is now, and shall be forever.
Glory to you now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, may your graces, your blessings, and all your divine gifts descend in abundance on your church, your parishes, monasteries, and convents, that we may raise glory to you now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy guests for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth, to him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord our God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy body, and our souls purified by your redeeming blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for new life. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Amen. There will be a meeting Tuesday at 6 p.m. for the planning for the coming of the patriarch. Hopefully by then we'll hear from the deacon in Lebanon and we can finalize our suggestions to make them reality. Allah, God willing. And after the closing blessing, we'll do the 40-day liturgy for On These Clouds, Edward and Frieda Nancer. That hymn is on page 29 in the songbook. To sing along with it, hymn for the 40 days. Holy Father, our mouths accustomed to earthly food, give you thanks for your grace that has made us worthy of this heavenly food, the body and blood of your only Son. Through him and with him, glory, power, and honor be to you and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
O Christ, you are the heavenly bread who came down and became for us the food that does not perish. At your second coming, may we not become the food of the imperishable fire. We raise glory and thanks to you and to your Father and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and blessings you have received from the forgiving of the Lord. May the blessing of the Most High Trinity accompany you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the one God to whom be glory forever.
Amen.
Love, the fragrance smoke in the scent of sweet perfume, O Lord. Eternal